Hey guys, Mike from CCTV Camera Pros here. I'm doing some more testing in this video using our Viewtron Auto-Tracking PTZ camera. It's that 4K IP PTZ that you see there behind me. And in my last video, I did some auto-track testing using intrusion zone detecting, where you basically set up a rectangular area in view and any objects that enter that area will be tracked. And in that video, I was tracking both cars and people, but mostly demonstrating cars. In this video, I want to show you a couple things. The difference between the intrusion detection and line crossing detection. I'm going to set up line crossing detection this video, and with line crossing detection, instead of it being an intrusion anywhere in the area, the object has to cross the line in one direction or the other, or both. It's configurable. So in our plaza here, suppose I wanted vehicles or people to only be tracked as they're entering the plaza, I'd want to use line detection tracking or line crossing tracking instead of intrusion detection. So in this video, I'm going to set up a couple of line detection zones in that same area over there as my last video, but I'm only going to detect humans, and I'm going to walk through the intrusion zone way down the lot here to the next plaza. Actually, it's a gas station, and I'll be about 560 feet away. I know that because I measured it out for my first video where I zoomed in on a truck that was exactly 560 feet away, and I'm basically gonna walk to that parking spot.
Here's the live view on the Viewtron IP camera NVR. To set up the line crossing detection, I'm gonna select settings from the menu down here, and then go into the AI event perimeter detection. Right here on the dropdown, I'm gonna select the 4K PTZ camera and then check this box to enable line crossing detection. With the mouse, I'm just gonna draw a line here across the entrance of our plaza, and I'm gonna reverse the direction there because I want to detect people coming into the plaza, not leaving. I'm gonna click apply. And then if I go into target detection, I only have human objects checked. I'm not gonna detect any cars or other types of motor vehicles. And then I could set up push notifications, pop-up video, email alerts, and these other alarms, but I'm not going to. And I'm gonna set up a second line crossing zone right here. And I'm gonna leave this one bi-directional. So if people cross this in either direction, that will trigger the alarm and the PTZ auto tracking. And again, I just want to ensure that I'm only detecting humans for this. And then another important thing is you want this trigger track to be checked, and you want to lock the PTZ so that it uses auto tracking, not manual tracking. When I'm done, I go into camera and then select smart tracking, and then select the 4K PTZ camera again. And the tracking mode should be PTZ auto tracking priority. The still time setting is how long it should stay still if it's tracking an object and that object's no longer moving, how long it'll stay focused on them. So now I'm gonna go back to the live view of the 4K PTZ. If I wanted to, I could enable that visualization so you could see the detection zones, but I'm gonna disable that. And then here I come. I'm actually watching myself in the Viewtron iPhone app. And when I'm gonna exit the plaza, and you'll see it does not trigger the alarm and the auto tracking when I go through the line crossing in this direction, exiting the parking lot. But I'll turn around in a second and come back in. And then when I cross the threshold of that line that I drew, it's like a virtual tripwire, you'll see that the PTZ auto tracking begins. So it starts to zoom in on me, and you'll notice it doesn't zoom all the way in. It keeps like a nice overview of the objects that it's tracking. It does zoom in and out, but just not too close. It maintains like this level of zoom throughout the auto tracking. Here's what it looks like on the mobile app right now. So I also was recording the mobile app. I'm using the iPhone, but it's the same for Android. And that's a video screen capture in the lower left of my iPhone app. And the iPhone app works excellent. I'm actually working on another video right now to show how great the presets the preset locations and the manual controls work in the app. Panning and tilting in the mobile app is really great. You just tap anywhere on the screen and it centers that point via panning and tilting automatically. And then to zoom in and out, you press buttons, a positive and negative button. But for the panning and tilting, you just tap on the screen anywhere. It's really nice. So I'm going to continue to walk further and eventually get to the parking lot of the gas station that's next door to our warehouse. And eventually, I'll at the farthest distance, I'm about 560 feet away. And you'll see it still does a great job of tracking human objects at that distance. And then you'll see when I go behind, you know, a tree, it doesn't get confused. It still tracks me accurately, even going through objects that are obstructing the view a bit. Especially over here, there's this big tree frond in the way, and it still continues to track me, which was a good test. And then again, at the furthest distance, I'm slightly closer than that 560 feet away that I did the test on a few weeks ago. I'd say right there, I'm about 540 or 550 feet away. That SUV in the background, I think that's one spot further than the truck from my last video, and that was 560 feet away. So let's just call this like 530, 540 feet away at that furthest distance. I'm gonna speed up the video so we don't get too bored here. Plus it looks like I can run faster than I can. So I do wanna come back and show you how the camera will also pan all the way to the other side. It's continuing to track me from that initial line crossing event. It will do that until I go out of view completely. And that's the same for car detection as well. Once a vehicle object or human object crosses into either an intrusion zone or in this case the line crossing detection, it will continue to track the object that crossed that threshold until that object is no longer in view or until that object is still for a period of time that exceeds that setting that I showed you a minute ago on that auto tracking screen. So now you can see it's actually zooming out as I get closer to kind of maintain this level of zoom throughout the tracking. And then when I go out of view, it'll pause here for a few seconds and then return back to the home position. And this was good timing because that car is crossing the line as well, and you see it does not track the car.
Guys, I hope this video has been helpful, and I didn't mention it earlier, but hopefully you're watching this on a 4K monitor so you could see the full resolution of this 4K PTZ camera. A couple other things. Obviously, it's outdoor rated. Actually, it's IP67 weatherproof rated, which is a very high level of weatherproof rating. Does great in rainy areas. It's fine in cold weather conditions. It's meant for rugged outdoor use. Although I didn't demonstrate in this video, it has IR night vision built in, so it works well in low light environments and even zero light environments. In addition to the auto-tracking PTZ functionality, you can also manually control the pan, tilt, zoom of that camera from the NVR it's connected to, and also from the mobile app for iPhone and Android, and also from the Viewtron desktop CMS software for Windows and Mac. Guys, if you have any questions about anything related to this 4K auto-tracking PTZ, or anything in regards to security camera systems for home, business, and government, you can reach out to me anytime. I can be reached at mike@cctvcamerapros.net. If you want to learn more about this auto-tracking PTZ camera and see additional video demos that I made, please visit www.cctvcamerapros.com/4kptz. Thank you for watching.